Is it working? Yay! Isn't technology wonderful when it works?
How you doing?
Hi, David. How are you?
I've got my recorder.
Excellent, excellent. Yeah, we'd really like to get something in soon. So, yeah, that would be great.
Yeah, I told him, like I said, I have to ask when I got that postcard.
Yeah. Were you aware that that whole committee had been sort of reconstituted again?
Well, I remember a couple years ago talking about this band.
Yeah.
I had made money about it.
Oh, yeah. It really got it started again. So, yeah, I'm trying to get new members in, a little more energetic. Yeah. We really want to be a little more, more outreach to the community, more events, more data collected, because that's really what we go through this stuff. Find out what seniors need in the community and then report back to the
board. Yeah, well, I think that was what I was
talking about. We already got.
Generally, it breaks down into transportation, health services, you know, broadband, there are several things, you know, needs that are always going to exist, probably. We've got some really specific recommendations this year that I think the county may actually be able to follow up on.
Well, I mean, that's basically the last year.
I know, it's a shame.
That'll be quite a shame.
There are a couple more seats.
seats left, so if you want to take your seat, we'll get started.
Thank you.
Chairman Gregory Strickland, who is the head of the school board.
Good afternoon, everyone. Oh, we knew better than that. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
That's what I'm talking about. So I want to thank all of you for joining us today. My name is Greg Strickland, and I have the privilege of serving as chairman of Louisa County School. And when I woke up today, I thought about the ceremony. So I thought to myself, this is a very special day. It's a special day for our school division, but it's also a special day for our community. And it only feels right. Most importantly, they didn't stand alone. When you look at this market closely, you'll see the words with the leadership and support of the parents, community members, and the NAACP, and those courageously sought and obtained equal education to serve our country. They took that step because they had a collective group around, of people around them who believed in them and their cause. Not everyone believed in them, and it certainly wasn't easy. But again, they felt, as Dr. King would later say, their life had ultimate significance. So we're here today to honor that significance. Again, I want to thank the Historical Society, the NAACP, the Louisa County Sheriff's Office, the Board of Supervisors, and members of our school board for making this possible. But most of all, I want to thank all 13 of those students to make sure that all students will be welcome at Louisa County School.
Because he was here at the same time, so he was actually one of our
Yeah.
Back, I was talking to my good friend and chairman of our board of supervisors, Dwayne Adams, and
And I was excited to meet him. And then I met the woman that changed my life, my wife Teresa. And then as I ended up staying here, the more I stayed here, the more I began to understand. There were 13 brave, bold, adventurous young folk who walked the halls of Louisa County High School to begin what we have today. I didn't know that, and I taught Louisa County history. Okay, I taught it. I taught it for 10 years. I knew it today. And it's because of you, it's the Historical Society. Whatever you guys do, don't stop now.
Yeah. that implied that mental device students treated blacks as if we were, it was like a rainy day. You can't do anything about it, so let's kind of not get wet by staying out of the way. The project team also expanded the interview process to include a few of the white students who then in 1965 and also interviewed one teacher, Coach Gerard. We invited 20 white students to interview, only about half agreed. You can only imagine why those others chose not to. But the experience of the white students was probably like schools anywhere. They came together, met new friends, joined with old friends, joined clubs, organizations, joined sports teams, and probably for the most part, paid little attention to the few black students who were there, which is typical. But for the black students, it felt isolated. Having come from an African American school where your friends joined clubs and leadership positions, not available. Most students came from Major Richardson, is not yet appropriated. They were an organization that played sports. At first class, when they came to Louisa County High School, there was no sign to say blacks are not allowed. But without anyone inviting you to join those clubs, also went down and come and join me. With the exception of two, Joe Morris and Steve Wright, who joined the basketball team, very few other blacks were able to join the organization. It's not my desire to put a dark cloud over this event. A few of the black students I interviewed shared that first year, and for some subsequent years, was traumatizing. They're still hurting from that experience today. When I did the interviews, it was pretty hurtful for me, and I was one of those students, that it was painful, and they would have less stories being told. That's why I'm kind of sharing some of this now, not to make anyone feel bad, not to give anyone a head, but for those who were hurting from that experience, and some are still hurting, believe it or not, they wanted us to know, others to know, what it felt like that first year. But I'm grateful to all these students who agreed to be interviewed, black and white. Is it Classmates have been to my home, I've been to classmates' homes. Classmates from 19 that I knew from 1965. Mary Nicholson Moody, Lynn Guilford Wagner, I consider my sisters. Those two plus Patsy Hart Johnson came to my dad's homegoing 20 years ago. Steve Montgomery gave remarks at Joe and Jackie Morris's wedding anniversary celebration. I think we can all agree that this country is divided and is making us weaker. We all need to push through these painful memories, political barriers, and reach out and connect to those who are different. Our Creator gave us two commands. One, that we love Him. Two, that we love each other. We need to put politics aside, some color, religion, economic status aside, and come together. I remember saying two requests. This is my first request. Come together. Back to why we're here. We're here to acknowledge my fellow classmates from 1965 who stepped up to break the color barrier. And its donors for making African American history a priority. This in itself took courage in a culture that for generations had celebrated the way of life that minimized or marginalized others based on their race or economic status. I want to also acknowledge our past executive director, Ms. Carlene Kovacic, and also our current executive director, Caitlin Coughlin, for their absolutely fantastic work. Greg DeRozio with DeRozio Communications for doing the design work on the marker. Rhonda Gill with Midtown Printing and Design, Mr. Greg Strickland at School Board, Dr. Strela and the entire Lewis County Public School System that did so much, Mr. Christian Goodwin, who was a supporter all along throughout, the Lewis County Board of Supervisors, Chairman, Vice Chairman Baldwin, who's here today to spoke, Sheriff Lowe and Community Strong for their final support, Virginia Commanders, and the Charlottesville Area Community Foundation. And let us not forget the NAACP. Thank you for coming to this close, but they were the backbone for driving the change that occurred. We acknowledge and appreciate all these groups and these individuals, but we all know that all praise and honor goes to God. Right? All this is because of Eli in the right time. Lastly, if you think these projects like this is good for the community, for the Lewis and Scandal Historical Society to keep this work up, we need your financial support. We need your volunteer time. Before leaving it today, I would ask that you write a check, make a pledge. There's a pledge envelope in the back. Anyone who's trying to pass as a board of directors, please support this work. If you like what you see, there's so much more to be told. This is a milestone in the journey. This is not the end point of what we started to do. There's so much more, but it does take funds and money. So please give. And that was my second request. So I'm done. Thank you all.
Thank you. Good afternoon to everyone. I am Mrs. William Mason. And I stand here for my husband, because he has transitioned. When we came to Louisa County High School, Steve Montgomery used to call him Breeze. And the reason he called him Breeze is because the way he walked. Yeah. And he was 5'7", and he walked like a man who was 6'2". And he had his head tilted to the side.
That's him.
That's how he felt. And during the 65, guys and girls didn't wear tennis shoes. They wore regular shoes that you had to shine. William Mason shoes shine because the way he carried himself. Now, he also had a reputation because his mom was a teacher also. Earlina. So I just want you to know that William has a son somewhere in the audience. Janelle Mason. And we lived in Keswick, which is Altamont County. And Altamont County did not play. No matter what color your skin was, if you had any inkling of being anybody or anything, you could do it.
Yeah.
If you wanted to be a ground keeper, they would teach you how to be a ground keeper. If you wanted to be a doctor, they would teach you how to be a doctor. And Janelle would tell anybody today, the reason she's gonna be a doctor, and let me tell you, my son's a teacher also in Richmond, Virginia. But Janelle would tell you all, when Janelle was in the second grade, one of her teachers told us, your daughter can't read. Your daughter can't read. She needs to work on her reading. So her daddy and I had a schedule. He worked nights and I worked days. He would pick the kids up from school. They would go to the downtown library in Charlottesville, Virginia. She was required to go select the book, come to her dad and sit at his feet and read to him. So now Janelle can read inside and outside of a book because of her daddy. So don't let nobody tell y'all you can't do nothing, you can't be anybody, because you can. Now, I was married to the man for 37 years, the love of my life. And do I miss him? I miss him every day. Every day. But when I think about the goodness of God, and my husband told me, this is what I'm going to say. My husband told me, he said, when I die, I'm going to walk into heaven. I said, sure, me too. But you know what? There was a joke between the two of us. When he passed, we were at Mr. Watson's business, and my daughter asked Mr. Watson, she said, has anybody ever been buried in their shoes? And Mr. Watson said, you know what? Yes. She said, I want my dad to be buried in his shoes. Not knowing that her daddy had told me, I'm going to walk into heaven. So he walked into heaven. By the way he lived. Because I'm going to tell you guys, if you got a wife, love her like you love yourself. At all times. Love her like you love yourself. And if you do that, everything will just fall into place. And I really appreciate all that you all have done for all of these folks. And I'm happy that William was a part of this, and I know he's probably sitting looking at me and saying, Joel, stop talking. So I'm gonna stop talking. I want to also acknowledge the Williams sisters, Joanne and Cassandra, are here also. And other family members also. But thank you all for everything that y'all have done. And like I said, the man walked like he was 6'2, he was 5'7. Thank you.
That was crazy.
Thank you.
address.